Speaking of our show, we have a new guest that we're going to be talking to here in just a minute, Mr. Eric Bartowski. Eric, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
Hi,
I am
Eric.
Very well.
Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right. Eric, I'm Harry Boomer, local TV guy and internet radio guy with Lillian Piles, who's a casting director. Don't know if you know who I am or who she is, but we're going to introduce ourselves to her and tell folks just a little bit about you. It says in your bio you've been teaching middle level science for 9 years. Started the Bulldog Theater Company in Olmsted Falls, a middle school, which is, of course, the suburb of Cleveland. And he served as a director, choreographer, and technical director for a lot of productions. So welcome, man. We're glad to have you on the show.
Oh, thank you so much. It's great to be here. I actually have some of our cast and crew members with me listening in as well.
Wonderful.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, cast members.
Hi!
Very good. So I guess we have to be nice. I heard some young voices there.
Yeah.
So I have to be nice. And I'm a nice guy. So
I don't say
anything crazy. So,
yeah. On air, anyway.
Exactly. Now, what I do behind closed doors, that's a different story. Eric, tell us more about yourself, man. You seem like you have a very interesting career in life and that you've done a lot of great stuff. We're interested to know a lot more about you.
Oh, well, thank you. Teaching is my passion, and I've been here in Olmsted Falls going on 8 years now, teaching sixth grade science, and running our theater company, and it's really been great to watch it grow and blossom, and we've done all kinds of shows here. We do musicals, straight plays, we do some student-created work as well, and I keep telling all of our students, you know, the energy that they bring, I just want to keep offering them opportunities so they can express themselves through their art. It's been fantastic.
Now, it's kind of interesting that you would do science and theater, or science and dance. Talk about, those are two kind of divergent issues, but you found a way to marry them. Talk a little bit about that, how you bring those two things together.
I originally started out my college path going for theater. I went to Otterbein College, majoring in acting, and had a change of heart and decided I wanted to teach, because when I was in high school at a local theater called Cassidy Greenbrier Theater, I was teaching acting classes, and that got me into teaching. The science part came from my dad. My dad's a chemist, and I've just always been around it, and there's a lot of parallels in the magic of our natural world and the magic of the artificial world that we create on stage.
Now, you didn't blow up any labs, did you?
No, sir, we did not.
That's a good thing.
I do have a bed of nails in my room, though.
Do you rest well on that bed of nails?
It's a bit pointy, but not too bad.
I think I get your point, yeah.
So when did you decide that you wanted to be a teacher?
It was probably in my freshman year of college, and I had just finished my my first year of actor training, mm-hmm. and I really realized that my passion went to, you know, helping other people realize their potential, realize their dreams.
Beautiful.
And that's kind of what always drew me to the theater, you know, when I was teaching classes in high school.
How do you prepare for a role that you have? You're a method actor. How do you get into your character? Do you become him or her or it, whatever depends on, you know, what you're playing? And then, you know, how do you bring that alive on stage or on film?
My role primarily now has been as a director, and I had the fortunate pleasure of trying to coax that out of 48 kids. You know, in our musicals and our plays. And so I really try to approach it from a relatable standpoint for my students who are in middle school, and really try them to see the connection of a character to what they're currently experiencing in their lives. We're currently doing Mary Poppins, so it's kind of relatable. And for some roles, we've got, you know, Jane and Michael Banks, who are kids, but then it's a little harder for our Mary Poppins, perhaps, but she's doing an awesome job with it.
Great. So are you in any of your plays? Do you do a solo, or do you do, are you on stage at all, or are you just behind the curtain?
I am just behind the curtain. I really, I'm so proud of the fact that when we run our shows, aside from the curtain speech at the beginning, I run nothing. Everything is run by our 6th through 8th grade students. Every light cue, every set change, every costume, prop handling, everything is run by them, and I get to sit back and watch.
Beautiful.
You know, it's got to be a wonderful thing when you can look in their face, and when they walk in the door, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed and not knowing what's in store, and then they find something that really turns them on, and they begin to blossom, and you see things come out of them that they didn't know was there, and maybe things that you didn't necessarily see initially. To see them blossom like a rose petal opening up, a rose blossom opening up, you know, and greeting the morning sun kind of thing, just to be able to look and see them develop and grow, and to know that I played a role in that.
Yes, it's a beautiful thing to be able to be a part of that, and I think I mentioned the enthusiasm before, that the energy that they all bring to their roles, be it an onstage role or an offstage role, is just fantastic, and just being around that energy is it's a joy. I mean, I love coming to school every day.
That's great. Now, Before we go any further, let me reintroduce you, because we have people who are tuning in all the time here on Backstage. We're talking with Eric Bartowski. He's a teacher of a middle school. I've been teaching a middle-level science for 9 years. He's a choreographer, a director, a technical director, all-around good guy. Loves to interact with young people and bring out of them what is inside. And, you know, that's such a special gift and such a special calling to be able to see something in somebody, or to, you know, and then have them, like I said, blossom, because not everybody comes with the confidence to be able to be on stage, or to be able to handle the lighting or the costumes. And you give them a chance to put their hands on it, and when they put their hands on it, they tend to learn it and learn to love it.
Beautiful.
Oh, definitely.
So can we hear from some of your students? Can we talk to one of them, or two of them, or three of them? How many are there?
Of course. We have four students here. Do you mind if I pass the phone around? They can just say
absolutely.
Tell us who you are.
Hi.
Hi, my name is Kaylee, and I play the role of Michael Banks in Mary Poppins.
Wonderful. And how old are you?
I'm Carly, and I'm the stage manager.
All right, Carly.
I'm Caitlin, and I'm Mary Poppins.
I'm Mary.
Hi, Mary.
That's excellent.
I'm Claire, and I play Jane.
Hi, Claire. How old are you, Clara?
13.
My granddaughter's
Wonderful.
13.
Is she? Yeah. So how long have you been in theater?
Katie's going to take this one.
Okay. So I've been in theater since about the summer going into third grade. So I've been doing it for about 4 years or so.
Wonderful.
And I really love it. Okay. I have done 12, I believe, productions.
Wow.
And
that's
I
a lot.
Love theater so much.
You love it. Mm-hmm. So how do you memorize all your lines? Do you have is there a trick to it, or is it just hard work?
Here's Caitlin on that one.
Okay. Hi, Caitlin.
For me, I kind of just take it chunk by chunk.
Chunk by chunk. What's a chunk?
Like
a page?
Like scene by scene is what I mean. And if you know you're blocking, you know where you're going, I find that that helps.
Okay.
As you know where you're going to go and what you're going to say. Mm-hmm. And like the more you do it, and writing it down helps me a lot. So.
Okay. So what do you want to do when you get bigger? You want to be an actress on stage? You want to be a movie star? You want to be a science person? What do you want to do?
Here's Claire on that one.
Okay, Claire.
I've always kind of liked
marine biology, and like I like theater and dance, so I'm thinking of like doing like marine biology and then having like after like that, like having like theater stuff and dance stuff, you know?
Like enjoying your life, right? That's a beautiful thing, you know, being creative. You grow and be more creative as you grow, and that's a wonderful thing. And then you have your science, and then you have your theater for entertainment. That's a beautiful thing.
And one of the really nice things about it all is that you can do it all.
Yeah.
You don't have to just say, well, I just want to do this. You can do this, that, and the other thing and be good at all of it. So we're very pleased to hear you ladies are doing so well and being so enthusiastic about it, because who knows what tomorrow will bring and where you will be and how famous you will be. And even if you never become famous, you can become a good person and be a good person that I can tell that you are already. So, you know, that's a blessing all in itself. Just being around creative, good people brings some creativity and some goodness out of you.
Yeah, bravo. So maybe you guys might want to come and visit us here in the studio later on.
That'd be awesome.
We've had theater companies here, and we've had the whole crew here, and we've had the whole cast here. So maybe you guys might want to come and see what a radio station looks like and then come and visit us.
Yeah, we would love that. Thank you.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, this has really been great. And, you know, I'm a casting director, and I'm the resident casting director at Caramu Theater in Cleveland. And it has been such a thrill for me to cast actors for the stage. And I'm in awe all the time of how actors can memorize lines and do their dancing and do their creativeness on stage and not be nervous. So do you guys ever get nervous? Anybody?
The first time is always the scariest. Then
is
you
it?
Get comfortable and you're like, it's just like practice and
oh, it is
fun.
Oh, okay. So regardless of what size the audience is?
Yeah. I mean, you think to yourself that it's just like practice, and then all that nervous feeling just like goes away.
Wonderful.
Yeah, and there's something about being nervous that you ladies are too young to know probably who Frank Sinatra is. But Frank Sinatra used to say that if you are not nervous, you tend not to care. The fact that there are butterflies in your stomach says you care enough about what you're doing to be nervous about what you're doing. And he said, and once you get into what you're doing, those butterflies go away, and you use that nervous energy, you channel that into what you're doing.
Towards your entertainment.
And then there you go. I mean, the magic happens.
Wonderful.
After that. So being nervous is a natural thing,
yeah.
but it goes away. As you say, when you get into it and you get into your character and everybody's hitting on all cylinders and you know you're blocking and you know your cues and all of that, it's magic. It really is.
Most definitely. It's really great to see the progression throughout rehearsals. We have many students who are in our shows. This is the first time that they've ever been on stage. The students, you know, like Kaylee, who have been in performances before, and it's great to see everyone progress, and they, you know, work through their nervousness, and our final product is always really fantastic.
Wonderful.
Now, speaking of the final product, you guys have a show coming up, right, later on this month. Tell us about that, when it's going to be, where it's going to be, how folks can get tickets, come out and support you.
Awesome. Yeah, our run of Mary Poppins is happening next weekend. October 24th, 25th, and 26th, and it's happening here at our middle school cafeteria on Bagley Road, 27045 Bagley.
And when you say here, are you talking Olmsted Falls Middle School?
Correct, yes.
Okay. Keep going, I'm sorry.
And that's okay. Tickets are $5 for adults, $3 for students, and free for anyone willing to claim senior citizen status.
I like how you put that.
I do, too. That was very cool. It really was. Well, kids, you know, it's an honor to meet you guys via phone. Glad you were able to visit us here in the station. And we will have you back later on in the year, and then you could come in and sit in these seats and talk on the radio and come and visit us.
Oh, that would be wonderful. We are overjoyed over here hearing that.
Oh, that's wonderful. We will let our GM know that he has got to get you on the schedule and get you in here.
Oh, thank you. That's
You're welcome.
Very kind of you.
Oh, absolutely, because we need to expose our kids to as many positive things as we can. And this is one positive event that you guys could come here and visit us.
Eric, before you go, is there anything else you want to say about what you do, about the kids, about what the Bulldog Theater Company is doing? You got any special things coming up outside of the Mary Poppins production?
Yes, we, even though we are an extracurricular club here at the middle school, we function like a theater company. So we have three more productions happening this year. We have a monologue showcase happening in the winter. We have a 12-hour play festival happening in the winter where it's 12 hours for our students to conceive, write, direct, and stage their performance. And our final performance this year is going to be a production of local playwright Eric Coble's Gathering Blue, which is based on the Lois Lowry YA novel of the same name.
Wonderful. So how do you choose what your performances will be? Is it a collaborative between you and others, or is that something that you choose because you want to expose your kids to something different?
That's exactly it. As an educator, I'm really trying to focus, how can I, you know, expose my students to a wide and varied, you know, type of theater. So our musicals are on a three-year rotation. We do a modern musical, a classic musical, and then kind of an anything goes eclectic. Like last year we did Elf, the musical, based on the movie with Will Ferrell, and that was kind of our, you know, out there musical. Mm-hmm. So that way we have, at least in a three-year span, three different types of musicals. So someone who's in it from sixth grade through eighth grade, they experience all sorts of different types of musicals.
Very good. I think you're doing a great job. The kids sound happy and sound thrilled to do what they're doing. And I want to commemorate you for all that positive things that you're bringing to these young people. It's very important that you do that. And it's very important that a lot of adults do that. It's very important that they tap that creativeness in their body and their minds and spirit.
I agree with you fully. That's definitely what we strive to do, and I'm really blessed to be here at Olmsted Falls with my colleagues, because I feel like we strive for that every day.
Wonderful.
That's excellent. Well, ladies, listen, y'all continue to do well. Make us all proud. We look forward to seeing you on the big screen, on the stage, and every other place, okay?
Maybe Broadway.
Yeah. Y'all be well.
Yeah!
Okay, take care, guys.
Eric, thank you.
Thanks, Eric.
Thank you. Take care.
All right, bye-bye.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Made in fame and fortune.
Yes.
Have your picture taken to the newspaper.
Actually, I'm
fine. Besides having your extreme good looks, if I may say so.
Oh, well, I wouldn't.
There probably aren't words to describe your emotion.
Now, gentlemen, please. On the contrary, there's a very good word. Am I right, Bert?
Tell them what it is.
Right. It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Because I was afraid to speak when I was just a lad. My father gave me nails a tweak and told me I was bad. But then one day I learned a word to say we ain't a nose.
The biggest word you ever heard, and this is how it goes. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. You are Voice of Radio, broadcasting 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on voiceofradio.com.